Oh, do you put mango in it?
Oh!
Whoa, big mouthful.
I'm so happy.
Hugs. I love your hair.
It's got watery eyes.
Did you get mango in your eyeballs? Oh no, don't do that! Here. Oh, he's like a dinosaur, Dad. Oh, stomp, stomp, stomp.
Swimming pools. Yeah.
Say hello to the people down there.
Hello.
Okay, Dean just asked me to shave his neckline, and I was like, shaving down here, and then I got too close, and I was like, no, you're still hairy here, so when you shave this, and then it just got.
Just looked tall.
Just like you're wearing the vest, yeah. So then I just started shaving everything. There's a lot of hair, man. There's a lot of hair. Still more on there. And there's nipples.
Isn't that done, but?
No, you can't leave it.
Why can't I leave it like that? It looks good.
Just leave the nipples.
Or patchy.
What?
And patchy.
Patchy?
Yeah.
It's so hard to shave, eh? Look at it. It's so thick.
Now my pec's going to be like bulging out. Everyone's going to see how buff I am.
And shave his back as well, and his shoulders.
I was thinking about just doing one line down here.
No, don't do that. Go and do it.
No.
He wouldn't do it.
I really need your shaving expertise here, because I'm not good at shaving.
Yeah, but then if you take your shirt off, people are like, why hasn't he got hair on his chest, but he's got hair on his belly?
Don't say that. No, I'm not trying to shave my belly.
That'll take you another year. You're one hairy man. Are you sure you're on time?
No. I'm Indian.
So we've just brushed out all the knots out of Marzi's hair. She had a few dreadlocks underneath there, but we covered it in conditioner. Move forward a bit. Yeah, oh my goodness, it's down to your butt. Wow. And now there's no knots. There's some serious dreadlocks in there, like we contemplated cutting it, didn't we? Go play with Myla. Watch your movie. Where is she? In the cupboard. Go see. Say knock knock. There's their hangout. Hanging out in the cupboard. All right. See you later. So it is 5 o'clock and we have to be at the bus station for 7 o'clock. Doesn't actually feel like we're going, hey? Like we haven't even packed our bag or anything. I'm really actually dreading it. I'm really dreading it. Like the whole sleeping with a child on me in a bus, not being able to move very much, and then actually waking up at 5 o'clock and then being like, okay, we're here, but we're not actually where we want to be. We'll be in Udon Thani. And then we have to figure out how to get on a slow boat to the Thai embassy. Have we even Googled that? We need to Google that. Dean's gonna Google it now. Oh, I just hope everything goes to plan. I mean, people do it all the time, so it can't be that bad.
Yeah,
I'm sure we'll just like follow the person in front of us. Yeah. Yeah. And we're not taking everything with us because I'm 80% sure, just pulled that out of my butt, that we will be allowed back in. Just going off like what people have said. So I figure we'll just pack like one change of clothes, my laptop, all the expensive stuff we'll pack. But the rest of it can stay here. And then at some point we'll be allowed back in if it's not.
Even if we're not allowed, we've still got a couple of days. We've got until Friday. I've got until Monday before our visa runs out here. So one of us.
Oh yeah, we could come back in because I've got until Friday. Dean's got until Monday if you didn't hear that. So it's not the end of the world, I guess, if we can't come back in. I've eaten like half a loaf of bread today. And a crap load of fruit. So, oh, I've been getting a couple of emails lately about people just asking me what is it like living in Thailand with kids. So I might put together a video about that. Otherwise, I'm writing like these massive long emails, so I might do that. Yeah. We're ready to go. Aren't we, Huxley Wuxley? Milosaurus, are you ready?
Play-Doh!
Can't forget Play-Doh. Alright.
Ready.
Ready. Ready spaghetti.
Ready spaghetti.
This is our apartment. Goodbye, apartment. We love you. We'll be back in one day. See you tomorrow. Oh, little Huxley Wuxley. Yeah? You want to see? Say ready.
Yeah.
Good boy. Say ready to go.
Go.
Waiting for the bus now. We're at the bus station. Not much is happening. We've still got maybe 20 minutes before our bus gets here. I'll probably wait around for people as well. But this, there was a bottle sitting on the chair next to me, and it was like half full of water. And like really skinny man came up and asked me if it was mine, and then I was like, no. Or like in Thai, he said in Thai, but I'm assuming that's what he meant. So I said, you like, take it. And he took it and he tipped the water out of it and put it into this bag with all these other bottles. So I'm assuming that he makes money from finding bottles and then like trading them into the, like recycling them sort of thing. And you can do that in Australia as well, but it's like 10 cents a bottle, not even, like 5 cents a bottle. And then I felt really bad, so I gave him some, because we just bought some snacks and stuff like that from the snack shop here. So I chased after him and gave him some snacks. Because it's like, the snack was like 12 baht. And that could be his dinner, pretty much. And it's we're struggling for money, but then you think of it like how he's struggling for money. Like, he looked like he hadn't eaten in like maybe 3 days. So skinny, so kind of puts things into perspective when you see people like that. I think that's our bus. We're on the bus and it's like way beyond what we expected.
This is like first class on the
yeah, it looks like a plane. Look at it. We're in the,
and they got stewardess as well.
Yeah, stewardess. It is. What's going on with my hair, man?
What's the soup du jour?
Can I just talk?
It's the soup. I sense on that side.
I never even know what you're saying.
Snakes and daddy, please?
I forgot what I was going to say now.
Sorry.
Oh yeah, we're up the top. Did I say that? We're at the top of the bus. It looks like planes, so it's got all like the luggage and everything. The seats go back. This far back. What else? It's a bit squishy, but we'll make do.
It's only squishy because we're 2 kids on us.
Yeah, but there's heaps of leg room. Look at that. This this is better than AirAsia, don't you reckon?
Yeah.
For $20 Australian, this is pretty epic. And there's a little Chinese bun shop out the front. So we got black bean, I think it is, steamed buns, and they're really good. We also got some snackies. Yeah. Some popcorn.
And then I ate it all.
You ate all the popcorn, yeah.
And then